Hi, my name is Erik Reinert. I'm a software engineer that works in DevOps, and I'm also a content creator on YouTube and Twitch at the Alta 4 stream. So I created this course because I wanted to get as close to real-world examples as I could, taking an application deployment all the way from startup, growth, and then eventually to scale. In this course, you'll focus on taking an application in the startup phase, where we then containerize it, deploy it, and just get it out the door. After that, we'll improve the developer experience by adding automation with things like Terraform and makefiles. And then finally, we'll migrate all of our infrastructure to scale on AWS. Whether you're one person or a growing team, take the examples you've learned from this course and build the infrastructure that you need. And now we're ready to actually deploy our application. So you'll see here that I have a running application, FEM FD service preview. Fantastic. Let's do a new one. So I'm going to click create service up in the top right hand corner. And, you know, again, this deployment was set up and specifically focused on doing one thing and then being able to leverage that thing we just did. Right. So if we go back to our diagram super quickly, we set up a container image, we set up a database. Well, now that we've set up the container image, we can draw the line between app runner and the container image because we've already done that. And so that's exactly what we're going to do now. By going into the create service, it already is like, okay, cool. I want, you know, I can run container images. Which one do you want to run? And so if I go in here, I'll say container registry as my repository type, provider, ECR. If I click browse, I can click on the image repository that I want, in this case, FEM FD service, and then bam, you should see that latest tag appear, right? That means that now this application is going to deploy based off of that latest tag and that latest tag only. So I'm gonna hit continue, and you'll see at the bottom, look at that, deployment settings. I don't even have to worry about deployment, right? And so I can do manual, I can just tell it, hey, I'll take care of it manually, don't worry about that. But I actually don't wanna do that. Right, like what I really want to do is I want to say, tell you what, every time I push to latest, which is basically the same as like merging to main, right, then deploy my application. So you might be like, okay, well, how does that work in the sense of deployment? Well, we just built our CI pipeline. Because all I have to do is push an image to ECR, and then that will go out and be deployed, right? When you're talking about a startup phase and like not having CI or anything like that, we just did our deployment. You built the image locally, right? You made sure it was for the right platform, and then you pushed it to ECR. Well, cool. Now you can trigger deployments that same way too, meaning that you've enabled the developer to immediately start being able to deploy if they want to, right? So yeah, automatic is perfect here. And then it might tell you to create a new service role or use an existing service role. But the TLDRs is you want to use that app runner ECR access role. So if you don't have it, just click create new service role. It'll create the exact one that I'm using. Or you can click use existing service role and you're going to want to use the app runner ECR access role. So now what we're going to do is we're going to click next. And now it's actually going to ask us for our service name. So we're going to say FEM FD service. We don't want to spend a lot of money, right? Like we don't really know how much traffic we're going to take on or anything like that. So I would recommend starting as small as possible, right? Save the most money. We are going to be charging for or being paid for, or sorry, not paid. We are going to be charged for this. So let's make sure we just save as much money as we possibly can. And then the next thing, runtime environment variables. Perfect. That's exactly how we ran it locally. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create 4 environment variables that I want to use inside of this application. So the first one, the source is actually going to be, oh, look at that, parameter store and SSM. Oh man, it's like they were so perfectly integrated, you know? There we go. Parameter store will be the first one. Parameter store will be the second one. We'll make plain text be the third one. And then we will make parameter store be the fourth one. And so what we're gonna do is in each one of the environment variable names, if you were curious or might've guessed it, we're going to put in the environment variable names that our application expects. So client ID, client secret, right? Google redirect URL and Postgres URL. Right, so make sure you've got each one of those, Google Client ID, Google Client Secret, Google Redirect URL, and Postgres URL. And then the next thing I want you to do is I want you to open up another tab. Sorry. Unfortunately, when you build stuff in the cloud, you have to open up a lot of tabs. But I want you to open up another tab, and then I want you to go to SSM. So again, you can type in SSM at the top. SSM. And then go to parameter store, because this is the only easy way to get this. FEM, FD, service. And then I'm going to click on each one of these, and I'm going to get what's called the ARN. The ARN is effectively the identity or the identifier in Amazon of the resource. And so that's going to tell App Runner, remember earlier how I said services can use other services in Amazon? Well, we're literally doing that now. We're telling App Runner, hey, this is the location of my Google Client ID. So if I click on that, you'll see ARN right here. If I copy that, I'm going to paste it into this third line here. All right, so now I've just, so let me take a step back. I have added parameters to SSM, right? Meaning that users can now configure their application in a UI whenever they need, right? I have set up policies for the App Runner service to be able to pull those exact same credentials, right? So if I change them in the future, I can deploy new changes and new configuration values whenever I want, right? And then what I'm doing now is I'm mapping the path to where it exists in Amazon with the environment variable that should be used in the application, right? So I'm delivering circuit or secrets very securely at a very like early stage. So we're going to go into the growth phase now. Again, I do feel confident that you guys had a good experience of what the startup phase feels like. So let's try and improve it a little bit, right? Like we do want to make it so that we can not have so much of, like, we do want to get rid of those headaches. We want to get rid of the headaches of like maybe deploying and some of the other like stuff that we have to deal with. We don't want to change everything, but just some things, right? So here's our phase scenario for phase two. So we're shipping code, right? We have no integration process though, right? So we don't really have any way of like running tests or doing tests, right? We don't have a real delivery process. We do, but it still means that we have to manually build the image ourselves to deploy things, right? So it's still, when we go back to that chart, right, the computer on the right is connected directly to the resources, and that's because you have to manage those resources. So we want to replace that. We don't want to do that. We want to have some kind of like actual delivery process. However, we don't want to replace anything like massive. Like we're not ready to get out of App Runner yet. We like App Runner. It works. Like maybe some dev on the team's like, I hate App Runner. It's fine. It works. We can keep moving, right? So we don't want to like really change anything on that side of things, but maybe there's other things that we can do to kind of make this move and our growth, you know, a little bit faster. The goals in this phase are we want to improve data reliability. As you recall, we like manually copy and pasted SQL statements, right? Like we weren't really doing a great job of managing our data. And when you're managing a company, especially, you want to manage that data well, right? And can anyone guess what I may be alluding to that we might be missing? But they've been around forever. It has relation to databases. What's the one thing we have to run whenever we make changes to
migrations?
Exactly. Yeah. So we have no migrations, right? Like it's just copy and paste data and run. So migrations is kind of missing here, right? So we want to improve data reliability through that. We want to improve the developer experience. Again, it was a little clunky to like, you know, get everything up and running commands and stuff. It was like, oh, where's this? Like, again, that was purposeful. Like for you guys to have to remember, like, I hate remembering commands, right? Like, there's a way of solving that, and I'm gonna show you how to do that. We need to create an actual integration solution. So we want CI, we want an actual CI that we can lean on. We want also a delivery solution. We want a way of actually leaning on something that will deliver our changes as well for us, right? This is what we're gonna be building, right? Now, you might look at it and say, okay, well, it looks pretty similar, and it is. As a matter of fact, the front end side of it, right, the client experience how App Runner works, what it talks to, and what it communicates with is pretty much the same. However, you'll notice that there's space between the developers and the resources. And this is purposeful, right? Once you get to a point where you get more than one developer, you need to figure out a way of separating them from the resources and the infrastructure, right? Because that's more possibility of them breaking things or more possibility of things happening, right? And so what we're doing and the focus of this really to grow through or to grow into the next part, again, we're not just growing the application, we're growing the team. Right? The team needs to be able to deploy things automatically. The team needs to be able to update schemas and stuff. So with that, when we talk about growth, we're talking about the entire growth of the organization, not just the application itself. If the application itself grew, none of this, just the application itself grew, none of this would need to change. Like, why would it? It's just you. You know what I mean? But when you start talking about 2 people, 4 people, 10 people, 20 people, having a delivery process and something that automates all of those things for you is still pretty critical. And so just so that we are all on the same page, let's go back to our container service. If I go to staging, staging service. Okay, cool. So that all looks good to me. So I'm going to click on staging service, right? Go to tasks. Again, this is unhealthy and it's failing because we don't have our migrations ran. So I'm going to do, I'm going to run that make command and let's see what happens. All right, so there we go. The task has been ran. So now we're waiting for the task to complete, right? Now I should be able to go into here and actually go to just staging directly tasks and we'll see stopped. Actually, let's go here. Created 23 seconds ago, stopped. Okay, cool. So it was successful. The migration ran. Awesome, right? Because we wouldn't have gotten to waiting for ECS service to stabilize if we hadn't gotten a successful code. But if I click on this, which was the task that ran, you'll see a essential container in exit tasks or in task exited. But it's not saying an error. It's just saying, hey, just to let you know, this successfully closed, right? And if we go to logs, there they are. There's our migration logs. And so now if I go to tasks, or if I go to staging, staging service, we go to deployments. Hey, look at that. We're getting healthy. All right. So if we go to tasks here, we can see one running, health and metrics. Look at that. Healthy. All right. Awesome. So now, if we go back to our distribution, copy our URL. Oh, that might be the prod one. Hang on. Okay, yeah, this is the staging one. So grab this URL. Hey, we did it. So there you go. We now have an application running entirely on ECS. Behind a CDN, you know, on top of the image that we're running, configured by SSM.